Welcome to Ticker Markets. We have a special guest with us, Cotton Guru Mr. Manish Daga, Director of Cotton Association of India. So I would like to start this conversation with the pink bollworm attack, which is a huge issue in India especially.
Right.
And mostly key growing areas like states like Telangana and Maharashtra, which is facing this problem currently, and due to which cotton crops are expected to get damaged. So what is your outlook on cotton production for this season?
See, we have to see the whole picture. One thing is that sowing of cotton this year is less compared to last year. Last year it was 122 lakh hectares.
Okay.
This year we feel it is not going to be more than 115 lakh hectares. So sowing less by 4 to 5%. And then comes the yield part. Pink bollworm has a direct impact on the yield of cotton, that is the output of cotton per acre. And pink bollworm damaged the crop partially last year, starting from Telangana and then reaching Maharashtra. But this year the impact is seen from the beginning of the season. Last year we saw pink bollworm in October.
Mm-hmm.
That means that was the second and third picking for the farmer. So he had already earned something from the farm.
Mm-hmm.
So when the government gave a directive that to remove the plants, mm-hmm. many farmers followed it. But this year pink bollworm has come from the flower stage.
Mm-hmm.
And because of less rainfall in July,
mm-hmm.
and till now in many states of India and cloudy weather,
mm-hmm.
the spread of pink bollworm is much faster.
Mm-hmm.
That's why we are seeing more impact of pink bollworm this year.
So we have also seen that USDA has forecast higher global output. So how will it impact prices mostly on MCX?
See, USDA has forecast higher global output, but it has also forecast more consumption.
Yes.
So this year may be the fourth consecutive year where cotton consumption is more than cotton production.
Right.
So 4 years in a row, if we consume more than we produce, that means the price trend is expected to be higher.
After looking at a pink bollworm attack, so we are expecting lower crops this year. So how will it fulfill demand?
See, the main game changer this year is going to be demand.
Yes.
Because there are three main game changers in the market. One is government. They have already played their role.
Yes.
Government of India has increased MSP and US government has declared trade war on China.
Yes.
Second game changer is weather. It is already playing its role now, because in June the rain started well in most states of India, but July has not been very good for most of the states. And weather is going to have a lot of impact, because 55% of agriculture in India is rainfed.
Yes.
Because being a dominantly rainfed country, the significance of a good monsoon is so much higher.
Yes.
And third, as you said, is demand. Demand is growing in the world as well as in India.
Mm.
Like in India, so many new mills have come up which are fast production machine mills.
Yes.
They consume a lot of more cotton than the older mills.
Mm.
So demand is growing very fast.
Yes.
Against that, the production is not growing so fast.
So if there is a short of cotton in India, so will India import cotton from other countries like China, US?
That is another challenge. India has since 8 to 10 years has been a dominantly exporting country.
Mm.
We have never imported more cotton,
yes.
in the last 10 years than we have exported.
Mm-hmm.
So the tendency to export is much higher, because we are much reasonably priced.
Yes.
We are strategically located. All around us countries consume more cotton.
Mm.
China, Bangladesh, Vietnam,
yeah.
Burma, Myanmar, all these countries consume a lot of cotton, and India is a very favorable supplier to them. And at the rate at which the US dollar is moving against the Indian rupee,
yeah.
it is very less probable that India is going to import a lot of cotton.
As you know that about ongoing trade war between US and China, so what do you think that will imports from China will boost, or?
Yes, the trade war will have a lot of good impacts, a lot of bad impacts.
Mm-hmm.
Currently what we are seeing is the bad impact.
Mm-hmm.
Like countries like Turkey, China, their currency has depreciated very fast.
Mm.
And similar things are happening in India.
Yeah.
So the short term impact is that currencies will be damaged and countries will face these issues. The long-term benefit for countries like India is China is a very big importer of raw cotton. Until 2014, it was the biggest importer of raw cotton. And this year, because the stocks have halved in the last 2 years, they are again expected to come back to the market and import cotton. US has been a very favorable supplier for them since last 2 years. But if the trade war continues between China and US, China will most probably import less cotton from US due to the trade sanctions, and India is the most reliable, you know, replacement for China. So Indian cotton will be exported more.
So what is the sowing pattern we are following this current season?
Like I shared before, the sowing right now compared to last year and a 5 year average is less. Till the 8th of August that we are right now, we have sown in 112 lakh hectares of land compared to 117 lakh hectares last year. So evidently it is 5% less, and we will end at 5% less. So 115 lakh hectares about sowing of cotton throughout the country.
So how it will be for next crop year?
See, that is not a very good prospect, because if you sow less, the chances of a higher crop become less, unless it is compensated by a high yield.
Yes.
And because of erratic weather, we don't have to look at the monsoon averages, we have to look at the monsoon actuals. The average rainfall in India is not so bad as the actual rainfall in India. I'll just share an example. In a village in South Gujarat where cotton is grown, it is called Vighai, it has rained 100 inches. And in same Gujarat, and another cotton producing district called Kutch, it has rained only 1.5 inches. So against 100 inches in one place, it is 1.5 inches in another place within the same state. So you can see the indiscipline of the monsoon. So this will result in a lower yield, definitely, and followed by this pest attack and huge gaps of no rains, it is going to be very difficult to achieve a high yield, and we are going to see a very challenging situation as far as the total crop is concerned.
So, sir, like we know that government has imposed 20% import duty on
textile products.
Yeah. So, what would you want to say about it? Like, what is your view?
This is a very good step. The decision of the Indian government to promote Make in India was only half done. Unless you have good trade sanctions, you have good trade agreements, and currently the government sees the textile industry and values it as the second highest employing industry after agriculture. So to support the industry, they have over 300 items, they have increased the import duty from about 6 to 10% to 30%. This is going to definitely support the domestic industry.
So it will definitely help textile industry, but how it will help growers, farmers?
See, for the benefit of the farmers, it is very important that the industry grows.
Yes.
So if the industry is supported, if it is cash rich, if the industry grows, if the reserves are good, if there are less defaults, definitely the benefit will be passed on to the grower.
So when there will be fresh arrivals this season?
The Indian season officially starts in October. Its season is officially stated to be from 1st October to 30th September. So the season will start from October. Only North India will see some arrivals, and some arrivals in Maharashtra and Gujarat. But officially, and you can say substantially, the arrivals will pick up post Diwali, that is second half of November.
Like, do you think that it will impact prices like negatively?
Prices will be impacted positively. So
okay.
Because the more delay in arrivals,
yes,
the more demand and the less supply.
Okay.
So we see very good demand in the new season, but supply is
right now going to be very slow.
So once we have tight supply, especially the ending stock is going to be one of the lowest in last 7 years that India has seen, and that is also a matter of concern for the industry. So the prices look to go up.
Okay, so it is expected that prices will be positive.
Yes,
in coming
the raw material cotton prices will be positive
in
and subsequently yarn prices will also increase.